So as you guys all know, we've recently went to Yosemite Park, and so we've been posting this on our Instagram. If you don't follow us, consider following us on @AdventureBuddies42. And so we have been overwhelmed with some additional questions, so we thought we'd put together a common FAQ on everything you need to know about Yosemite National Park. Cue the intro. Question number one, do I need a reservation to go to Yosemite National Park? Normally, no. However, in May 21st, 2021, due to the pandemic, now you do need a reservation to manage crowd control. So you get a reservation through going online or through booking with one of your lodgings inside of the park. So make sure you understand this ahead of time, because we did see people unfortunately get turned away at the park entrance. And so speaking of no before you go, consider watching this video up here. We go over our top five things you need to know before going to Yosemite.
When is the best time to visit Yosemite? Well, really the spring and summer. The spring it's nice because the snow is melting and the waterfalls are at the best. Summer obviously is more popular because that is the time that a lot of people have vacations, although the waterfalls can start to dry up toward the end of summer and beginning of fall.
But it should be noted, there's no bad time to visit this beautiful national park. Question number three, how much does it cost to get an entrance fee into the park? Well, as of right now, you can get a 7-day entrance fee for about $35 for one vehicle. Vehicle has up to about 10 to 15 people per vehicle. So $35 gets you in for the entire week, but you can use less if you don't plan on staying there for 10 days. And if you are considering not staying for 10 days, consider checking out this video here where we go over our best 2-day itinerary where we jam-pack adventure in only 2 days. So keeping in mind, it should also be noted that these park entrances are open 24 hours a day. And so that means you get into the park early to beat the crowd, but you can also stay as late as you want. And if you aren't staying in Curry Village, then you can head on out of the park to wherever your final destination may be, and the entrances or exits will always be open for you.
Question number four is, where should we stay if we're looking to stay within the park? You know, there are a few options. There's Yosemite Lodge, there's a Wahine Hotel, and our favorite is Curry Village. Click on the link above to learn more about Curry Village.
Question number five, is there Wi-Fi and good cell service? Well, yes and no. So keep in mind, this is a national park with tons of trees and wildlife and not the greatest cell reception. However, there are a few key spots where you can get Wi-Fi and cell reception. And so those are Yosemite Lodge as well as the Awani Hotel. And so if you do need to hop on your phone for any sort of personal or business reasons, consider making a pit stop there to get all your Wi-Fi needs.
Question number six, where can I see the giant sequoia trees? Well, really at the west entrance, as soon as you go in, you go to the Mariposa Grove. There you can see beautiful trees, walk through them, take amazing photos. We highly recommend this.
So last question, what would be the number one hike that we recommend doing while going to Yosemite National Park? And that has to be Half Dome. Half Dome is a 16-mile hike that requires a permit to get on, but allows you to have a cabling experience up the face of a mountain that offers some breathtaking views. Now, if this hike isn't for you because it is fairly strenuous, then we consider checking out this video above where Jake and Gianna walk you through their top five hikes to do with kids in Yosemite National Park. So there you guys have some commonly asked questions that we've been fielding over on our Instagram. And so if you like this video, please consider giving us that thumbs up. If this was helpful, consider subscribing down below. If you have any more questions, consider dropping us a comment and we'll be sure to get back to you. And so if you or someone else you know are going to Yosemite, consider sharing this video with them, because after all, life's an adventure.
Who are you going on it with?